everyone. Welcome to my channel. So I hope you're not getting too tired of pages out of seasons, but I do have a lot of people who are kind of following along with my progress in this book, and I've had a lot of positive feedback about them appreciating the videos that I'm doing for this book, or out of this book, I should say. So I am going to continue on with that. Occasionally, I will be doing works out of other books when I kind of get motivated or inspired. But right now, I'm seriously concentrating on seasons. So today's video, I am going to work on this page here. Now, this page has a few issues with it that I'm going to cover up. First of all, there is some splatter here from when I did this page. I had forgot to cover up this page to prevent the splatter from coming over, so I will need to cover that up, as well as there's a little bit of bleed through here. And I don't even know what this, I don't know if you can see it on camera, but there's some pink right here, which is kind of crazy right here and here, because I have no idea, it didn't transfer from this page. And this is the opposite page. Maybe it's from this purple. Nope. Kind of weird. So anyway, I've got some bleed through that I want to cover up. But this background stuff is not going to be difficult at all. This bleed through right here is from, I don't know if you can see that gold pen that I used right here. It was a Spectrum Noir metallic marker, and I didn't know that it was going to bleed through so bad. But yeah, I'm not worried about it. It'll be easy to cover up. So I am going to be using my Kuratake watercolors. I keep them with rubber bands around them so that they don't open up. So I'll be using that for the background. I know I've used it for a couple backgrounds recently, but I am just loving these. The colors are just so vibrant and beautiful. So I will be using those on this background. Also, this background will be a little bit different. I'm going to try something new. I have this stencil, cloud stencil here, and I will try, if I can find it, post the link for this in the description box below. But I'm going to try to make kind of like a galaxy cloud background. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw in some clouds first, and then I'm going to go in with my watercolors. And then sometime down the road, I will be using my, probably my Faber-Castell Pitt brush pen in white and my Prisma white pencil to kind of fill in those clouds once the watercolor dries. Also, I plan on using my Coliro Pearlcolors. I'm not sure yet which colors out of here I'm going to use. And where I want to use them. I have a feeling I want to do these stars in kind of a white or white gold color. But I always kind of just let the page kind of take me along on a little journey, so to speak. I never know exactly what I'm going to do. I usually have kind of an idea where I'm going to start, and then it just goes from there. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. All right, so here I got a little ahead of myself. I was so excited to do this background and try out the clouds that I forgot that I needed to lay down that masking fluid, especially around all those stars. There's no way I could do a watercolor background around all those stars without getting into them. So I had to put my watercolors aside and get out my masking fluid. Now, I have a link down below. If you are not familiar with masking fluid or, you know, want to learn a little bit more about it, I put a link and you can check that out for some information on masking fluid. All right, now that that masking fluid is applied all over on the edges of the image and dried, now I can go ahead and resume with the background. So I have listed the colors that I am using down below, and I'm trying something different with those clouds. I am using my white watercolor along the edges of those clouds, and then blending with the blue. It's kind of my first attempt at this, so you know, it's kind of an experiment, but it actually ended up looking really nice. Right, so here I just wanted to show that there was no bleed through and hardly any, I don't think there was any spillover along the edges. That paper towel did a good job absorbing anything around the edges. So now I'm taking my rubber cement pickup tool to clean off all of that masking fluid. All right, now that the masking fluid is completely removed, I'm just going around the edges here. You can see where there's some gaps where the masking fluid overlapped into the background, and just match it up the best I could with my pencils and just kind of fill in those gap areas. Also, I've been using this piece of scratch paper kind of throughout coloring this video just to protect my hand and the sleeve of my shirt from getting blue transferred onto it as I rest my hand on the page. All right, so here's where I go in with my Faber-Castell Pitt brush pen in white. And I'm just tightening up that line on the edge of the clouds there. And I do need to clean it off periodically because it is kind of picking up some of the blue, but it's actually working really well. And then I am going to go in with my white Prismacolor and do a little bit more blending and adding a little bit more white along the edge of those clouds.
Okay, so I like to use Gamsol with an old brush to blend my pencil work. But if you don't like to use mineral spirits, then by all means, use whatever blending method you prefer. But for me, it just saves stress and work on my hands and my wrist. All right, so here I've pulled out my Coliro Pearlcolors watercolor set in Ocean. I'll be sure to have a link for these down below if you're interested. And the color that I'm using from this set is called Green Pearl. However, I don't know why it has that name. There's no green in it. As a matter of fact, it's kind of just a whitish gold shimmer. So, yeah, I don't get that name. But anyway, I will be using this to add some pearly, shimmery accents to the page. Okay, so I've got my folk art gold acrylic paint, and I actually ended up making two wells on my palette with it because I am going to try something different. I wanted to kind of paint some lines with my acrylic paint, and I wasn't sure how watered down I needed it to be. So I made one well with it really watered down and another well with it not quite so watered down. And the one in the center, which is not as watered down, ended up being the one that I preferred. So I am just taking, right now I have a bigger brush just to mix it up, but I ended up using a really tiny, tiny line brush. I will put that down in the description box as far as the size. And, here it is, 2/0. Anyway, it's one of those really tiny ones for making little tiny lines. And I am attempting to make lines on these feathers. I'm not sure how well I like how it turned out, but you know, you never know until you try. All right, and so now I am taking my little dot tool and I am taking from the thicker mixture of acrylic paint that I have there and just placing some dots where Hannah had drawn in little circles on the bird there. And I also do some down in his tail, which, you know, in hindsight, I'm not sure if I really like. I think I got a little carried away with the dots. They're so much fun. But I think I made too many in his tail. But, you know, it's personal preference. All right, so here I have put some scrap pieces of paper underneath the page just to kind of protect my table and surrounding areas, and then some little pieces of paper on top of the main body of the bird. So when I go to apply the splatters, it doesn't get on the main bird itself and just mostly on the background. And this again is that green pearl color I was using a little bit earlier on in the video. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. I did try to get kind of a final shot here showing all of the glitter, but the light was really bright, so it kind of washed it out a little bit. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.